What is going on, world-class athletes? It's Grant VanderHayden, and I'm so excited and thrilled to be your coach here today. And I know how valuable your time is, so we're gonna jump right in with three of my best drills and progressions that's gonna allow you to transform your two-handed backhand, to finally hit with that effortless power, that confidence, setting up consistently to pop it just like that. And you're not alone. When I first started playing tennis, my backhand was absolutely awful. When I would step up, I would be really excited and confident to hit great shots, but it was really tight and tense, and it kind of looked something like that. And I didn't really know what to do to transform. So my journey actually began when I started coaching, and I reached out to all the world's best coaches and was so blessed to get offered a job to work with legendary master coach, Rick Macy, where I learned his secrets about how he develops two-handed backhand. And I also learned from one of the world's leading tennis scientists, Dr. Brian Gordon. And that really solidified my foundation as a coach and is what I believe is gonna allow me to really add a lot of value to you here today. The three step-by-step drills and progressions that you can implement the next time you step on the court. First, we're gonna start with what the optimal contact point is and why that's so important for you to master, as well as how you can do it. In the second section, you're gonna learn the secrets behind effortless power and how to use the biggest muscles in your body to consistently pop your two-handed backhand. And lastly, we're gonna close and cover with how you can put it all together and create that ATP backhand flip. Along each phase of the shot, we're gonna be using footage from Djokovic and Nadal from back angles and Djokovic and Nadal from side angles. So you're gonna get that rock solid intuition and a visual understanding of exactly what you need to do the next time you step out on the court. So without further ado, let's jump right in and start mastering your perfect two-hand backhand contact point. So taking a look at both Nadal and Djokovic's contact, you'll see that as they accelerate, they're gonna make contact with their non-dominant arm positioned in front of the body just like that. This is the first section that you're gonna master, and I'm gonna provide you right now with a step-by-step sequence that you can use to automatically ingrain it into your muscle memory. But before we start with that, it's super important to know, like, why is this so important? Why is getting that contact point in front so powerful for you? Now, the primary reason why these top two-handed backhand players get this contact position in front is because by having the arm in front of the body, it's gonna unlock two massive benefits for you. Benefit number one is having the arm position in front is gonna allow you to tap into the bigger muscles of your non-dominant arm, like your pec and your shoulder, giving you that added leverage and that added pop on the two-handed backhand. The second benefit is that by having the non-dominant arm straight in front of the body, it's gonna allow you to create the maximum amount of surface area from the racket face, thereby generating so much more topspin and added consistency into your shot just like that, giving you that confidence to know you can hit it really hard and have it still go in. So the exact step-by-step process for you to follow when you step on the court with some balls ready to feed yourself, you're just gonna go ahead and load up in a neutral stance, a little bit more than shoulder width apart. From there, you're gonna go ahead and grip the racket with your non-dominant arm, emphasizing that index finger higher than the rest of your fingers. This is gonna give you even more leverage at contact. From this position, you're gonna go ahead and prep your racket lined up with your back leg, with the wrist in an extended position, so the butt cap should be facing towards the net, just like that. From there, you're gonna focus on shifting your weight from your back leg to your front leg while simultaneously accomplishing two other motions. Number one, you're gonna be rotating your trunk and you're gonna be pulling your arm away from the body and forward into that contact. And one thing you'll see with especially Djokovic, notice how as he makes contact, that left arm is gonna extend all the way through straight in front. That's really the key to getting that awesome effortless pop at contact going forward just like that. So what you're gonna do is keep feeding yourself and really feeling that body get all the power at contact. You should feel very easy on that left arm. And once you get comfortable and used to making contact with that arm in front, getting power from the body, we're gonna graduate into the next progression. So let's jump right in. All right, world-class athletes. So with a rock solid intuition and feel of exactly what that contact should be and how to get that forward momentum, we're now gonna incorporate using two hands in generating more power from the trunk, from the legs, from the core, just like that. So here's the exact step-by-step process to follow. Now what you're gonna do, feeding yourself, you're gonna go ahead, instead of being in a neutral stance, you're gonna load into a closed stance. And the reason why the top players in the world use the closed stance on the majority of their two-handed backhands is that the closed stance allows you to achieve more torso rotation. And one of the main sources of power, and really the key to popping it with that satisfaction, is by generating so much power from that rotation of the trunk, which is why that closed stance is so common and so powerful. So you're gonna go ahead and load into that closed stance. And now, instead of having an abbreviated preparation like we did in the first drill, what you're gonna do is you're gonna grip the racket with two hands, and you're gonna bring that racket face behind the back leg at around the knee level. So it's gonna look something just like this. The second thing that you really wanna emphasize here is when you get your racket back, what you wanna do is make sure that the dominant arm is completely straight and away from the body, pointed back like this. And a key checkpoint that allowed me to really transform and start feeling so much pop on the backhand, just like that, is when you take the racket back, you actually wanna feel a stretch in your lat, in your back shoulder right there. The reason why that is so powerful and transformative is because now when you accelerate from your leg drive and rotation, because that right arm is straight, it's gonna create a stretch back. And this in biomechanics is called a stretch and shorten cycle, which basically means that when you accelerate going forward, this muscle is gonna be stretched and it's gonna give you so much massive pop, and you're gonna learn how to get even more of that in the last section of the video. So, quick recap, you're gonna go ahead and load into that closed stance. The dominant arm is gonna be straight, the left arm is gonna be straight as well, and the racket face is gonna be lined up with the back knee, just like that. From this position, you're gonna focus on, just like we did before, shifting your weight forward, driving off of that right leg, rotating the trunk, and straightening the left arm, going up and away to contact. Now adding that feeling of the power from the leg drive and that right arm as well going up into the shot. Once you go ahead and feel that, you've mastered it, we're gonna graduate to creating that ATP racquet flip. And one final note is, while you're doing these drills, you and I both know that transformation takes time. But what can really make your process of transformation so much more enjoyable is to know that you're on track. Because when you know you're improving, when you know you're on track, everything becomes so much more fun, because it's not like guesswork. You actually know you're making those improvements every single time. So I highly advise that when you're implementing these drills, that you're following the exact checkpoints you learned and using video feedback to make sure that you're actually implementing everything correctly. Because then, if it doesn't feel right, you're gonna be able to go back and notice it. And once I started using video, and I use it with all my students, so transformative. So you've mastered the contact, you've now got loads of effortless power coming from those bigger muscles. Let's close with exactly how you're gonna create that perfect ATP racquet flip. All right, world-class athlete, the last and final section that you're gonna master is the ATP racquet flip. This is the last universal quality that every top two-handed backhand player does on every single backhand. And the reason why it's so important and so valuable, and is truly the key for you to get even more power and spin just like that, is based off of what we covered earlier in the second section, which is the stretch and shorten cycle. So as you understand now, when the best players in the world accelerate, with the dominant arm being straight, they use the bigger muscles of their leg drive and rotation to pull the racket forward with the body, creating that stretch and therefore added acceleration of the racket face into contact. Now, to amplify that to the next level, we're gonna create the ATP racquet flip. And basically, the reason why this creates even more power and more spin is because instead of starting with the racket already in this downward position, we're now gonna start with all the same checkpoints, except the racket tip is now gonna be positioned up and away at approximately a 45 degree angle. Now, what's gonna happen is, as we accelerate now, we're gonna shift the weight forward, we're gonna drive that right leg, we're gonna rotate the trunk, then we're gonna pull the dominant arm forward from those back muscles, and lastly, we're gonna straighten that left arm up and away. As all of that's happening, the natural weight of the racket is gonna lag behind which is gonna create a downward and opposite force going backward, and also the opposite direction of where we're gonna be traveling the racket going forward. This added opposite force creates an even deeper stretch, even more resistance in the acceleration of the muscles going forward. And as we know, the more that we can stimulate these muscles in an antagonistic fashion, the more we're gonna tap into that stretch, the more we're gonna be able to generate that pop going forward into contact. And I'm just telling you right now, it feels extraordinary. So here's exactly how you can develop that ATP racquet flip. Now, it's super critical here is that to create the flip, do you think that your wrist should be more tight or more relaxed? Of course, it's relaxed. So to stimulate that, we're just gonna begin with some shadow swings. And what I want you to do is, if you naturally have a lot of tension in your wrists, what you can do is actually grip your racket with your dominant arm with just your index finger, just like that. It's gonna create a lot of relaxation, and you're gonna automatically start feeling so much more of that racket face lagging back. So again, here, the wrists are relaxed, and what's causing the flip is the weight shift, the leg drive, the hip and trunk rotation, the arm pulling forward, and the left arm straightening. Creating that all together, you're gonna feel this nice, effortless lag on the racket face, just like that. And feeding yourself, you can vary from having the grip with the index to having it with the full, and using video feedback along the way to make sure that you're implementing everything perfect and correctly. All right, world-class athletes, that concludes this backhand drill progression video. I'm so thrilled to have been your coach. I hope you got loads of value. I hope you're feeling inspired and confident that you can reach a world-class level on your two-handed backhand. If you're interested in taking this further and getting more individualized and customized feedback and support from me, you can go ahead and click the link in the description, and I'll see you on the next video. Let's go.